you think about your personal safety on deck? All the time? Once a day? Once a month? What are you doing to protect yourself at work? This is the story of four members of Logos Hope who thought they would never get hurt on deck, but they did. Meet Hannah and Renske. They were looking forward to going home, reuniting with their boyfriends, and had plans to get married, when they ended up with severe back and head injuries. Renske was doing an incredibly simple routine that anyone could do easily, but was too lazy to change her shoes. She slipped, and not only did she injure herself, but she injured Hannah, who made an incredibly annoying noise afterward. And with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the Gospel of Peace, Ephesians 6:15. She would have been better off if she'd just done this. Notice how he protects his airways, can see clearly, and wears the necessary hand protection. Or could it have been this? A watchkeeper thought he was funny and decided to play a cruel, practical joke.
Attention ship company. Dolphins on the bow.
Renske forgot it was dry dock and went hastily to the bow. Hannah, meanwhile, was doing a standard paint upgrade and never thought she was at any risk. But she was wrong. Renske, unaware that she was working there, was so excited to see the dolphins that she lost all sense of reason. This could have been easily prevented if dolphins weren't such magical animals. And you shall not go up by steps to my altar, so that your nakedness will not be exposed on it. Exodus 20:26. Meanwhile, Elias got stuck in a box. Or maybe it was this. Renske had another unbelievably easy task of lifting a box, but it proved too heavy for her. Somehow, Hannah was also incapable of lifting it. They both ended up with severe, lifelong back injuries. With him is only the arm of flesh, but with us is the Lord our God to help us and to fight our battles. 2 Chronicles 32:8a. If Renske had taken just a little time to assess the situation and called for help after noticing that the box was too heavy, she would have been fine. Remember, it's important to stretch before doing any heavy lifting.
I'm stretching, Anna!
Oh, me too, Renske!
Are you ready, Hannah?
Yes, I'm ready. Are you ready, Renske?
Yes, I'm ready! Let's hit this box!
One, two, three!
Oh, it's so easy now! Let's have a drink! Good water!
Nice. Teamwork.
Yonah was experienced and professional, but it took just one mistake for him to end up with a broken leg and severe bruising. How could it have happened? For example, did it happen like this? He was out taking photos of the small Navy vessels nearby, however, wasn't paying attention to his surroundings while doing so. He was focused on getting the perfect shot to show his buddies back home. The previous day, Bianca had been on anchor watch and showed no interest to clean up after herself. As a result of his and his colleague's carelessness, Yonah fell victim to a nasty injury.
Whoa! Thank you.
stuck in the horse bike for hours. Don't live carelessly, unthinkingly. Make sure you understand what the master wants. Ephesians 5:17. But Yono wasn't to blame, was he? That's not what his wife thinks.
What is the matter?
Or was it this that caused Yono to potentially never walk again? After having had a long, hard day at work, Yono was tired and had heard a rumor that there was a swimming pool on deck 9. He wanted to check it out so that he could end his day relaxing. He was looking forward to it. He was so excited, however, that he didn't care to think about his own personal safety.
Is there room for one more?
He ran on a wet deck. Due to his inappropriate footwear, he caused great damage to his legs. Many injuries occur when someone is running when they shouldn't be.
Hey, ladies, who wants a pizza? Oh my goodness, what happened here? We said that we go together in the pool! Man, could you wait for me? Oh, man! Hey, you're not... Oh, I don't want to be here anymore! I don't know.
Survey the path for your feet, and all your ways will be sure. Proverbs 4:26. He should have approached it like this, wearing sensible footwear.
Is there room for one more?
And taking necessary precaution. Then he would have been able to relax and enjoy his off time with his fellow crew members, listening to his favorite
music. Hey guys! Cannonball!
Jerry missed the pool. If he had just taken out a working aloft permit, then he would have known this was unsafe. Marco was about to apply for an official SP for the fourth time when he ended up losing a hand. Could his accident have been caused from this? He was doing his weekly fire routine when he let his eyes stray from the Lord's path.
Oh, hello, beautiful. How are you doing today? It's so good to see you. You look amazing.
He should have kept his hands to himself. Sheol and Abaddon are never satisfied, and never satisfied are the eyes of man. Proverbs 27:20. Or perhaps this is what happened. He was using a powerful tool without wearing any gloves while listening to music, so he lost focus. Marco lost not only his hand, but his chance at SP.
It's not unusual, you want to be loved by anyone.
It says in Genesis 9:7, but as for you, be fruitful and multiply. Spread out across the earth and multiply upon it. But he won't be doing any of that anytime soon. Don't end up like these four. Know the dangers of what you are working on and keep yourself safe.
Always remember, keep safety as your number one priority.
It's not unusual to be loved by anyone. It's not unusual to have fun with anyone. But when I see you hanging about with anyone, it's not unusual to see me cry. I wanna die. It's not unusual to go out at any time, but when I see you out and about, it's such a crime. If you should ever wanna be loved by anyone, it's not unusual, it happens every day. No matter what you say, you'll find it happens all the time. Love will never do what you want to do. Why can't this crazy love be more? It's not unusual to be mad with anyone. It's not unusual to be sad with anyone. But if I ever find that you've changed at any time, it's not unusual to find that I'm